Hello and welcome. Our topic for the day is simplifying radicals. Before we go on to start our questions, let's understand the steps behind how to simplify the radicals. So let's read it out. Here are the steps required for simplifying radicals. Step 1 is find the prime factorization of the number inside the radical. Start by dividing the number by the first prime number, that is 2. And then continuing dividing by 2 until we get a remainder. After that, we then start off by dividing by the next prime number, that is 3, 5, 7, etc. until the only numbers left are prime numbers. So the next step is determine the index of the radical. The index tells you how many of the kind you need to put together to be able to move that number or variable from inside the radical to outside the radical. For example, if the index is 2, that is, we're given a square root of a number. So that means we need to move 2 of a kind from inside to outside. But if the index is 3, that if it is written like with a 3 over here, then we need to move 3 of a kind from inside the radical to outside. This is our second step. Step 3 is move each group of numbers or variables from inside the radical to outside the radical. If there are not enough numbers or variables to make a group of 2 or 3 or whatever is needed, then we leave the numbers inside the radical as it is. All these steps will be clear when you go on to solve our questions. So let's just read the last step over here. Simplify the expression both inside and outside the radical by multiplying. We multiply all the numbers and variables inside the radical together and at the same time multiply all the numbers and variables outside the radical together. So let's understand these steps in our given questions. Simplify 5 square root of 45. So we have 5 root of 45 as the question given to us. Now first step is to find out the prime factors of 45. So what will we do? 45 can be written as 3 times 3 times 5. So we write down 5 outside the radical, put the radical sign, list the prime factors, that is 3 times 3 times 5. Now here we notice the index is 2. So that means we have to make groups of 2 inside the radical. This is possible with this 3 only. 5 will be left alone. So now this pair of, that is this 2 3s will come down, come outside the radical as a single 3. So 3 times 5 outside the radical. Inside we are left with only 5. So now we combine and simplify the numbers inside and outside the radical sign. Outside we have 5 times 3, this turns to 15. And inside the radical, only 5 will be remaining. So this is the final answer, that is 15 radical sine of 5, or we read that 15 root of 5. This can be seen in option D. Let's move to the next question. This says simplify and we're given 19 root of 320. This is our question. So first we have to find out the prime factors or list down the factors of 320. So let's do it over here. We first start with the number 2. We are left with 160. We can again divide this by 2 and we're left with 80. Again by 2, 40. Further by 2, 20, 2 by, we get 10, 10 divided by 2 is 5. Now further here we cannot divide by 2, neither by 3 which is the next, so we divide by 5 and 5 times 1 is 5. Now we write this as 19, we put the radical sign and we write down how many 2's? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 2's with 5 there. Now we see that the index of the radical is 2, that is, it's a square root symbol. So now what we'll be doing is we'll be clubbing or making pair of two numbers, that is, we'll be combining 2, that is 1, 2 and 3. So now here we have 3 pairs of 2's. So every time they will occur like 2 times 2 times 2 outside the radical times 19, and inside we're left with 5. So now we'll simplify outside the radical. So this is 8 times 19. This is 152. And inside the radical we have just number 5. So our answer is 152 root of 5 can be seen in option C. Let's do the next question. Simplify negative 3 root of 432. Our steps remain the same. We first do the prime factorization of 432. We divide 432 by 2 and we're left with 216. Then we again 108. This is again divisible by 2. We get 54. 54 is divisible by 2 as 27. 27 cannot be divided by 2 since it's not an even number. So we choose the next prime number, that is 3. 3 times 9 is 27. 3 times 3 is 9. And 3 times 3 is 1. So now we'll list out all the factors inside the radical. 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. That is 4 2's. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 3 3's. 1, 2 and 3. Now we'll do the combining. Since it's a square root, the index is 2. So we'll be making pair of 2 numbers each. So this is how we do it. And inside we are left with only number 3, while outside we get 2 times 2 times 3 times the negative 3. So we'll do the simplification outside, that is 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 3 is 12. 12 times negative 3 is a negative 36 radical 3. So this is our final answer, can be seen in option A. I hope simplifying radicals is easy now. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.